Hello, welcome to part 6 of this playthrough of Sunless Sea. I may make this the last part, because I don't really play adventure games all the way through. At least you can maybe figure it out for yourself what's what. I think I need to move the screen a bit, don't I? Just push it up a bit. I'm looking for Mount Palmerston, wherever that is. W to speed up the boat a bit more. It's supposed to be northeast of here somewhere, so I think I'd better follow the coast in case I miss it. Dream of a vast eye. So what I did was undock and redock and kept it. Let's just check the prices here. Oops. I was just looking at this screen again. I think I'm going to move it up a little further. Read the last line there, just. Okay. Go. The old port report. Don't think I have anything yet. Terror, there we go. One Sooth and Cooper long box. Ah. Oh, I can send it to station 3. Well, could do. All right. Why not? If I don't buy the stuff here. Wrong buttons. snow. Some bats. I can get some free food, I suppose. Don't know what this other stuff is, though. Well, somewhere up here, it's snowy, but somewhere up here then is this place, maybe. I'll get the old port report anyway. Shore leave for the crew. One idiot goes to jail. There you go, fine. Explore the town. Okay. Bit an echo on one of the simpler riddles. And some other time, right? Now then. These dodgy straits again, where I wasn't able to go any further north. So how can this place be northeast of London? That's what puzzles me. I have to slow down because it gets rather difficult here. Up. See, the map has stopped scrolling. Thoughts of home come at the strangest times, it says here. Now, what happens? Highgate. frost found, the castle where riddles fight questions to the death. For while there, you are somewhere beyond places. Perhaps you've survived. The scars of the north, returning to port, lost one fuel. Lost four crew. Oh yeah, there's not much fuel left. 50 terra. Ooh. And 8 supplies. No shop. Take tea with the squatters. In a pleasant few hours, lost 10 terra. I only have one supply. One extra supply. Is it? I can't go there. With so much terror. Supplies. One. Ah. I'm probably doomed. Unless we can go and fight some darn critter. Let me go up here. Northeast again. Mission anyway. Am I not able to go faster? No, I'm not. Maybe the water's a bit thick. Is going to get hungry at some point. Then I'm stuck. Maybe I should head south and look at the chart. Do I know? Up over here somehow. And I need to get back to anywhere where I can buy some food. I don't think I can make it quickly. Stoddard's Haven? I don't remember it. Let's get down there. Maybe I can. Why is my engine so slow? Oops, stay away from that whirlpool. Go any faster, but I can eat some chocolate. Now I'm sailing slowly. There we go. Why is it so slow? Is it just the icy weather? Yeah. I could lose a bit more terra, maybe. Oh. Best ahead for Duplair. Hey man, help me fix the engine. This is a problem, but I don't know what the cause is. Two crew, is it these guys? Shouldn't be eating chocolate, really. There you go. Fed the crew, presumably I have no supplies left. Unless I'm mistaken. Oh, it's these guys again. Oh no. Report done. more hassle. That would fix the war. I failed to broker a union. Maybe I should just steal that flipping star and be done with it, yeah. A tough challenge. Got it. And fight over that. Idiots. Right. Check my chart. I should probably go south of the Maelstrom to Fieldhaven. Is it going so slowly? What have I done to my ship? Why isn't the engineer fixing it? Supplies. None. Okay. This hunger isn't increasing rapidly because I only have two crew. Ooh, got that nightmare again. Flee the nightmare. Lost one rest for a night. Succeeded in a hearts challenge and gained one Terran. 96. Oh dear. Your dreams have passed. That's good. Phew. Lost one Terran. 95. still. That is 96 terra. I guess I go insane if I don't get back to port and spend a number of restful nights. I didn't realise it was so high. Now, why is this engine slow? What's happened? Station 3, I have some cargo for it, don't I? But 96 Terra. 100, oh dear. Dock. Yeah, I think that's a good idea. A navigator. It's the first office I ride. Bingo. Maybe he will help. Supplies, yes. Oh. 5 fuel. Supplies are expensive. But I have no choice, really. I must not run out. Fuel, I must also not run out. I think I'll be alright. 5. Ah, it's because I don't have enough crew. And that's why terror is increasing faster as well. More food or more fuel? Food. Let's check the map. Here, so I could actually go there quickly and drop off that crate. Fish. catch him. Deal with it later. Let's park first. Oops. Grumbling from the crew, the stairs are sharp-edged and wet. The box is heavy and its contents inclined to shift. After a few slips and a bad bruise to the shin, you resort to placing crew members along the stairs and handing the box along. There's a warehouse at the top of the stairs, but it's not apparently your destination. Another sign points along the narrow path towards the building with the spire. Deliveries, it says, more aggressively this time. Someone in the spired building is singing. The song sits with teeth on edge. Slippery and lined with mushrooms. You and your crew struggle with the boxes, but they get lumpier and more awkward. I guess that's the mushrooms. The mist gets into your clothes. The building with the spire looks further away now than it did when you started on the path. Terracing has not increased. This quality cannot currently increase past 100. Iron 25 failed a challenge. Try again and you may have better luck. One of the shadows moves. An austere acolyte steps into the light. She's covered head to foot in protective black, her fingers thickly gloved and goggles perched on the top of her head. It's plain she's unimpressed by what she's seen so far. Deliveries go up this path, she said, nodding towards the steepled building. Deliver the box to these shores and no further. Not much later, you are standing in a mist watching a parade of clay men. They hoist the boxes on their shoulders and march away, surprisingly quiet, towards the building near the steeple. Yet an austere acolyte leads them, her lamp swinging on a chain. Follow because you've been paid, follow because you're curious, follow because the singing has got into your bones. I've been paid. You follow the procession at a slight polite distance, but not so polite as to suggest that you're beginning to go away. There are many other boxes there already. Take the crowbar with the box. Corpse inside is permanently dead. Distension of the skin over the breastbone. Shoves a scalpel. Watch. Definitely only little blood. A heart-sized sphere of silver-grey metal. With a giant nutcracker, she cracks a sphere and another sphere inside that and another. Finally, in the centre, she crumples something heavy, small and black. She lifts it out with tongs and looks at it through her goggles. The song falters, but she manages to keep humming, though the words are lost. She puts the black and heavy thing into a jar marked with a word of the correspondence. She closes the jar and seals it with red wax. Finally, the corpse is removed again and the marble slab wiped clean. She comes to pay you. Thank you, she says. Return another day. I may have something else for you. A female secret. My quality is now 3. I've gained the acolyte's favour. Okay. some other time. Yes. Check map. Down there. I think I got a port report here on the way out, so I'll go past there. The only option I've got. Good. Messages. fuel and 10 echo. That for now, so I think that's a good place to stop the game. Let's just launch and then redock so it saves it. So that's it for the first playthrough of this game, and again get my fingers on the right keys and can do this right. Ooh. Good, okay. Now we're just out of dock. I think I might play this game on, but I think that's good for a demo. You don't want to see how it's all played or what all the things to discover are. play it yourself, maybe. Bye for now.